Dear friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel, MCB ChemTube. This is an online chemistry tutorial, and you get my previous videos from my personal homepage or from my YouTube channel. And we were discussing about the topic chemistry of functional group second, and in this second lecture, I would like to discuss or introduce a new functional group, that is carboxylic acid, its preparation and decarboxylation, and what is carb electrolysis. So our learning objectives are to understand the preparation of carboxylic acid from Grignard reagent, that's the one. The second one, to understand what is the mechanism of decarboxylation, and third one, what is mean by carb reaction or carb electrolysis. And before going to the details, let us discuss the basics of carboxylic acid and what is carboxylic acid and how does it name. And the carboxylic acid means that the functional group is formed by the combination of carbonyl and hydroxyl group on same carbon atom. Right? You can see it here, carbonyl and hydroxyl group, that is this one on same carbon atom. And usually this is a functional group, and alkyl or aryl group is attached to this functional group. And this is the condensed structure of carboxylic acid. And carboxylic acid can be classified into aliphatic acid, that means alkyl group attached to the carboxyl group. And the next one, aromatic acid, that is aryl group attached to the carboxylic acid. And third one, fatty acid. In fatty acid, long chain aliphatic acid derived from hydrolysis of fats and oils. For example, this is the smallest carboxylic acid, that is formic acid. And this is another carboxylic acid, propionic acid, this is an aliphatic acid, and here aromatic compound is attached to carboxylic acid, that is benzoic acid, it's an aromatic acid. And here you have a fatty acid, stearic acid, and you can see it's 16, that's longest and long chain aliphatic acid, that is usually derived from hydrolysis of fats and oils. Next one, how can you name carboxylic acid? Usually, first step is finding longest chain containing functional group, that is parent chain. Then numbering should start with the carbonyl carbon here, from here. And usually while naming an alkyne, E should be replaced with oic acid. For example, formic acid, this is a common name of this compound, but it is a methanoic acid. And this second one is acetic acid, is a common name, and ribosine name is ethanoic acid. Next one, this is actually longest chain is, parent chain is 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is the parent chain containing functional group. And here you have a substituent at third position, that is 3 methyl, and total 4 carbon is the butane, oic acid. Common name is isovaleric acid. And next one, this one is the parent chain, and you have a functional group, another functional group at fourth position, that is 4-aminobutanoic acid, or this is called alpha, beta and gamma, gamma-aminobutyric acid. This is the common name of this compound. So that's about of naming. Next one here, you have a carboxylic acid preparation, not aldehyde or ketone, and the carboxylic acid preparation from Grignard reaction. How can you prepare carboxylic acid from Grignard reagent? And there are two types of methods for getting carboxylic acid from Grignard. First method is bubbling gaseous carbon dioxide into either solution of Grignard reagent, or at the same time same reaction also can be done by pouring Grignard reagent over crushed dry ice or solid carbon dioxide. So this is Grignard reagent, and this is an organometallic compound. In Grignard, this carbon can act as a nucleophile because this magnesium is electropositive when compared to carbon. So carbon is more electronegative when compared to magnesium, so it is nucleophilic center, and carbon dioxide, of course this carbon is electrophilic center, so this negatively charged polarized carbon can attack this electrophilic center, and this double bond can break and it form RCOO minus here and MgX plus. An adduct will be formed. This is finally hydrolyzed by using acid into carboxylic acid. And example and the mechanism is shown here. For example, in the case of methyl magnesium bromide with solid carbon dioxide, you get acetate anion. Adduct of magnesium bromide like this. The mechanism is shown like the same as this one. And it forms an adduct first, then this adduct finally hydrolyzed by workup by using acid to form carboxylic acid. That's about preparation of aliphatic compound, and aromatic carboxylic acid also can be prepared. Here you have to put carboxylic acid. And the phenyl magnesium bromide with the solid carbon dioxide, it give an adduct first, then finally you can hydrolyze it by workup into acid, benzoic acid. Next one question is how to do the following conversion. You are preparing carboxylic acid from alcohol. So we have learned here the preparation of carboxylic acid from magnesium bromide, Grignard reagent. So you can think of preparing this carboxylic acid from Grignard first. So next one, that is, this is our product. So you have to think back. This carboxylic acid can be obtained from the same hydrocarbon with functionalized with magnesium chloride, our Grignard. And you can prepare from this Grignard. By treating this Grignard with carbon dioxide, you get trimethyl acetic acid. This trimethyl, not trimethyl. This is it is trimethyl acetic acid. Okay. And this Grignard reagent can be prepared from corresponding halide, that is tertiary butyl chloride, by treating magnesium. And this halide can be prepared from alcohol by treating tertiary butanol with HCl. So in that way you can think backward and find out the different steps for preparing any compound. Next topic is Cobbe electrolysis. And Cobbe electrolysis reaction is an organic reaction named after Hermann Cobbe. And the Cobbe reaction is a decarboxylate dimerization. Okay, this you have to remember this one, decarboxylative dimerization of two carboxylic acid or carboxylate ions. So there are two molecules of carboxylate anion. This on electrolysis it undergo oxidation, and it lose each molecule lose one electron. There are two molecules, it lose two electrons. And it form a radical first, a radical intermediate, then a alkyl radical will be formed. Finally, that alkyl radical combine to give a higher alkane. So it is used to prepare symmetrical alkane RR compound. In many cases, R is equal to straight chain to molecule. Usually, low yield is obtained for branched one. And also, unsymmetrical alkanes, higher alkanes have been also made, but you have to use different mixtures. So here, yes, you are getting symmetrical one, but if you are using different mixture, and you can also prepare unsymmetrical alkane. about the mechanism. It involves a two-stage free radical mechanism, and this is the first step. It undergo oxidation, and it's an electrolysis, and this carboxylate anion contain two electron, and each electron, these two electron, one each carboxylate group lose one electron, and two molecule lose two electron. Finally, if you lose one electron from here, you get corresponding radical. You can see here, if you lose one electron, you get corresponding radical, and that radical undergo decomposition like this, and it form and it decompose like this, and it form a carbon dioxide, right, and a R radical. Okay, two molecules of carbon dioxide will be removed from here, and it form two R radical, and these two R radical recombine to give hydroalkane. For example, in the case of acetic acid, it forms acetate anion, and this undergo oxidation to give acetate radical, and it undergo decomposition further, and it form 2-methyl radical plus carbon dioxide. 2-methyl radical recombine finally to form hydroalkane. And next, third topic is decarboxylation of carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid loses carbon dioxide. It's called decarboxylation. So this is carboxylic acid, and this loses carbon dioxide. What happens? This R and H combine to form alkane. Okay, you get a carbon dioxide gas. But usually the unusual stability of carbon dioxide may leads to decarboxylation. But in practice, we found that the reaction is very slow. Usually the reaction become rapid or faster when you have a functional group like this carbonate, a special functional group. If present, it undergo decomposition very quickly. So in the case of carboxylic acid, if it has a beta keto group, this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon, so this is beta keto acid. It undergo decarboxylation while heating 150 degrees Celsius. It undergo decarboxylation, and this hydrogen and alkane, this CH2 combine to form CH3. Then carbon dioxide is released. And the mechanism is as shown here. This undergo a cyclic transition state mechanism. A six-member transition state like this is as shown here. The carbon dioxide is released like this. This hydrogen released, and the electron from this OH bond transferred towards this bond, and this bond decompose, the break, and it form a carbon dioxide. Okay, carbon dioxide. Then this form a double bond, and this double bond break, and you can see that a double bond is here, and this becomes single bond, and this O minus take up hydrogen, and it form enol, and this enol and ketone enol isomerization, it form ketone. And usually decarboxylation of carboxylic acid take place by treating sodium salt of carboxylic acid with the soda lime. And when you treat sodium salt of carboxylic acid with soda lime, it form corresponding alkane and sodium carbonate. So sodium methanoate with the soda lime, this is sodium methanoate with the soda lime, gives methane gas. Similarly, aromatic carboxylic acid, also benzene is obtained. This is benzene is obtained by treating benzoic acid with the soda lime. Okay, that's all about the carboxylation, decarboxylation. And in summary, we have learned the preparation method of carboxylic acid from Grignard reagent, And also we learned carb electrolysis of carboxylic acid, and it gives hyaluronicamide. And we also learned decarboxylation of carboxylic acid with sodalene gives alkane, or carboxylic acid with a special functional group like carbonyl can undergo decarboxylation readily. Okay, that's all. Thank you for watching.